India since March 2014. Mr. Aditya was brought up in Delhi. He studied B.Tech Biomedical Engineering from Sadibaba University from 2005 to 2009 and pursued MSc Sports Biomechanics from Dobaro University during 2009 to 2010. In his post-graduation projects, he had worked on 3D motion analysis to investigate the various factors involved in sprint bowling in cricket. He has expertise in sports code Elite software, which he is using for the performance analysis of the Indian national hockey team for men. He has been working as a performance analyst or a biomechanist for the Sports Mechanics India Private Limited since May 2013. He has been responsible for providing biomechanical analysis of cycling and gait analysis. He has been responsible for the 2D and 3D motion analysis and deriving meaningful statistical analysis. Recently, he has been to Olympic Games Rio de Janeiro, Brazil 2016. With this brief introduction, I would like to welcome Mr. Aditya on behalf of PSG College of Technology and Biomedical Engineering Department to share his views in biomechanics, a career perspective, and inspire our students in the field of biomechanics.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Am I audible? Okay, so I don't need a speaker. Okay, on the outset, I would like to thank head of the department, biomedical engineering, all the teaching staff of biomedical engineering, PSG Tech, for inviting me here for the guest lecture. And not taking any credits off from you guys, all the students, thank you for being here today. Well, before I start, is everyone able to understand me? Firstly, audible to everyone? Everyone's able to understand me? Good, okay. So today, at the end of the session, when we leave this room, I'd like everyone, each and every person in this room, to be inspired. Yes? So I want you to be inspired because you are going to see the career perspectives that you are going to go and have in the future after you finish your course. And I want to be inspired by the urge and hunger that I see in your eyes that you're going to go grab those opportunities and make it big. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. And two promises we make in this session. One, I promise I won't make this session boring. Okay? So no one's sleeping. Second, I want to promise from you guys, I want it to be an interactive session. So it's not one-way communication. It's two ways, yes? So that I know you understand what I'm talking here, and second, you're not sleeping. Okay, let's start. Am I okay here, or do you want me to be there? Am I good? Okay. So the title of my presentation today is Biomechanics, a Career Perspective. So before I start, I'd let you know about a bit about myself. I finished my schooling in Delhi, Kendriya Vidyalaya, and after that I did my biomedical B.Tech, Biomedical Engineering, from Sadibaba University, Chennai. I was one of the decent performing students. I was never a top student, okay? So, I was a cadet captain in NCC. Passionate about singing. Don't ask me to sing today. And then, I was a cricket player. I want you to focus on every single slide here, and if you've got notes, take it down. Why? I'm gonna come back to these slides and refer these points afterwards. Because whatever I'm here today, it's because of something which has already been mentioned in these previous slides. So after doing my undergraduate degree, like most of you will have questions, what am I going to do next? Am I going to go get placed in an IT company? Am I going to get placed in a biomedical company? Or am I going to go for higher studies? So I decided to go for higher studies. So I did Master of Science in Sports Biomechanics from Loughborough University, which is the top university in England for sports research. Top university, top course. I mean, I was so glad to choose the course. I learned the subject, and more importantly, I learned the skills. So it's not about reading the books and just cramming it and then writing it on the sheets, answer sheets. It's basically learning the skills. And then I thought about the ways to implement them. So I finished my postgraduate degree in 2010. And then in 2011, my professional career starts. So what did I do in that 1 year? I applied for jobs. A lot of them. When I say a lot, I actually applied for a lot. 440 applications to be precise. And guess what? I got rejected in all of them. Some of them, they didn't even reply back. Some of them, they said, not now, maybe tomorrow. 2011, I got my first work opportunity as performance analyst for Loughborough Students University Men's Hockey Club. So I did my postgraduate at Loughborough University, and then I worked with the hockey club of the same university, which was playing in Premiership of England Hockey League. That's like Ranji in cricket here, Ranji Trophy. That's how it was. So I worked with them to start with as a performance analyst. 2012, I worked as a performance analyst for England under 21 men. So this is 4 years back. I'm 28 years old now, but still young. So 4 years back, I was 24. For a 24-year-old guy or a boy, to get an opportunity to work with an international team, it's not a mean achievement. So I worked with them as a performance analyst. And by 2013, when my contract was coming to an end with England Hockey and Loughborough University Men's Hockey Club, I decided to come back to India. 2014, I got my first work assignment. How many of you follow hockey here? Don't be shy if you follow hockey. Even if you're one, raise your hand. Thank you, no one. Okay, so I started working as a performance analyst for Hockey India League team, Punjab Warriors, in 2014. That was my first season. And soon after the end of that season, I was called upon by Hockey India for the role of lead performance analyst. This is 2014, that is 2 years back. 26 years old, working for the national team. When you stand in that crowd, in front of so many people, so many spectators, players, the national anthem going, and you hold your hand to your chest, that feeling is unexplainable. That I can't express, and you won't feel it right now. So how did I start? So right now when you guys are sitting here, I've been told some of them are from the final year, and some of the students are from pre-final years. Correct? Okay. So right now when you sit in this room, you should have three questions in your head. Can you read it? Three big questions that should run through your mind. Any guesses what they are?
What I'm going to do in the future.
Are you going to sleep soon? Yes, thank you. Any ideas?
What I'm going to do in future.
Might be?
What I'm going to do in future.
Okay, good. That might be true. Come on, interactive, the promises. I told you it won't be boring. I told you you have to be interactive. What might be the questions?
What am I going to do?
Sorry?
What kind of career will I get?
Okay, that might be, might. Anyone from the boys? Come on. Oh, you have a test tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Brilliant. I thought I'll just have a 20-minute session. I might just go for 4 hours now. Okay. Who plays cricket here? Yeah, when there was hockey, no one raised their hands up. Good. Okay. Catch. What does it say? What does it say? Now that's mining, yes, but on the other side. Yes. So the first question that should build through your mind right now is why? Be loud. I'm not enough. Yes, why? The second question, any guesses?
What? How?
How?
Maybe. Catch. Don't be scared.
Squat.
Yes. The next question is what? And the third question.
How?
Have you seen my slides before?
No, sorry.
How? Yes? So, why, what, and how? What significance do they have here? So when you're sitting in this room, when you ask these questions to yourself, you'll think, you'll ponder, karamada karamada sattam kekumla, and you'll amaze yourself from the response that your brain gives to you, the response that you give yourself. It's not your teachers, it's not your friends. You ask these questions to yourself, and you will get the response. So when you ask why, dream is the answer. Why were you here? There were so many courses. Information technology, computer science and engineering, or whatever it is, CSE. Triple E, ECE, ETC, biotech. But why are you here? Because you had a vision, you had a dream. You wanted to learn something in this field. Maybe true, maybe may not be true. But I'm going to talk, because this is how I started. சரி வந்தாச்சு சேர்ந்தாச்சு படிச்சுருக்கோம் டூ இயர்ஸ் போய் த்ரீ இயர்ஸ் போய் ஃபைனல் இயர் வந்தாச்சு. நெக்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் வாட்? ஷி மிஸ் தி எக்ஸைட்டிங் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தி செஷன் அண்ட் இட்ஸ் ஆல் போரிங் கோஸ் சாரி. நவ தி நெக்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் வாட்? வாட் ஆர் யூ கோயிங் டு யூஸ் வாட் எவர் யூ லேர்ன்ட் தட் கிவ்ஸ் யூ தி பர்பஸ். Yes? And the next question was how. When you ask how, what is that?
Path to go.
Correct. Whoever said path is correct, or the way, the direction, path. Missing more and more. So when you ask these three questions to yourself, you ask, why did I take this course? What am I going to do with this? And how am I going to do this? Yeah. So the title of my presentation was Biomechanics, a Career Perspective. Yes? So the icon here, what can you see? It's a human skeleton model. It's sort of running. Not really, but yeah. Posing. His joints are highlighted and he's in process of a gait. So that's basically an icon of biomechanics. Correct? Well, I was bored with this. Who's gonna sit there in a lab just study bones and their movements, blah blah blah? So I wanted to make a small change. So that was icon of biomechanics. Any idea what this is?
Sports.
Yes. I chose sports biomechanics. Implementation of biomechanics in sports. Cricket பார்க்குறோம், ஆடுறோம், எல்லோ ஸ்போர்ட்லாம் பார்க்குறோம். ஐபிஎல் வருது, whatever. I don't follow cricket much, so I wouldn't know of the tournaments. What is TNPL வருது, என்னென்னமோ வருது, அவ்வளோ ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் பார்க்குறோம். Why can't we just implement that here? That was my sole idea. So I'll give you a brief about what I learned, or what you might learn in biomechanics going forward. If you go for higher studies, so what you might learn. So basically, it's 2D motion analysis, two-dimensional motion analysis, three-dimensional motion analysis, high-speed motion analysis, and then 3D modeling and simulation. 2D motion analysis. What set of equipments do we need to run this. Okay, listen, it's gonna get boring for a while. Yeah, but then I want you to stay awake. I want you to be awake for a bit so that you go to the exciting part soon. Yes? So you basically, you can do a 2D motion analysis using a normal video camera. You can even use a phone camera. You might use a treadmill for gait analysis. And then you just need a basic visualization tool. So as I was explaining to the department head a few minutes back, so you can use a treadmill, you can ask the person to walk, and you can have a rear view camera focusing there at the feet, for example here. And you just need a basic visualization tool to give you like basic details about pronation, supination, or if the knee is buzzing in or going out, that sort of stuff. So you only need a visualization tool. Or maximum you might use a software that gives you angles and lines and all that. What's the angle between two joints, or between two segments. But then the next is 3D motion analysis. So 3D, three-dimensional motion analysis is basically adding one more dimension to a two-dimensional motion. This can be done in two different ways. Yes? One, it's using the same simple camera, but then multiple number of them, so that you can get different angles of it, and you just calibrate them, you feed it into a software that gives you one human model for you to study from every side. Yes? What I used here,
position sensor,
as you can see, are light reflective markers. So that's a human without a head. You see these white dots? So these are basically markers. It's got a head that reflects light. So you mark the subject at their joint segments. As you can see here, so that's a front view, side view, 45 degree view. Yes? So when you're using light reflective markers, you need to use special cameras. As you can see here, there's a special camera which has got red lights there. So what does this camera do? It emits infrared radiations, which then gets reflected by the light reflective markers, and that is then taken in by the camera lens. And there are multiple number of them. And then these cameras feed the information to a digitization and data collection software. Who did I give the ball to? Thank you. Okay. So I use this. This is the exciting part if you are interested. So I use this technique to study the various factors that affect spin bowling in cricket. Cricket, wake up. Yeah? So I did this project with England and Wales Cricket Board, and we had about 20 subjects from sub-elite, elite, and international levels. Have you heard of Graham Swan?
Yes, sir.
James Treadwell?
Yes, sir.
Michael Yardy? Okay. So they were there in the test. So what the test was about is, what are the different factors that affect off-spin bowling? You watch cricket, in off-spin bowling, what do they do? Roll the arm, release. That's how I used to think. The more the person rolls the arm, the more the ball spins. Yeah? So when we actually use these models, they give you the realistic answer. So here, so we mark the subjects, we ask them to bowl in a controlled environment, and then we made models, 3D models of them. This is not the one, but we made 3D models. So basically what we found there, the release point in spin bowling, the index finger, who plays cricket? Okay, you get up. He's holding my camera. Come on. Okay. Don't throw the ball away, just show the release finger. And how do you release? Okay. So can you see that? Can you go slow motion again? Okay. Yes? So this is what we think. Maybe he's doing a top spin. He might be an expert. I'll see. Yeah, so this is what I used to think as well. So there's an angular release that spins the ball more. But then as we did the test, the trials, what we found out, all the 25 subjects or the test participants, the release point of the index finger was straight. So the ball was released like this and no angular displacement there. So the ball was released with a straight finger and the angular displacement was at the wrist. So I rotate the wrist and release the ball like this. Yes? But would that alone generate the spin on the ball? No.
Moment. Angle.
So the more we studied, what we found out is the release itself wasn't enough to spin the ball as much as we want to do. So it actually started far beyond. From there to there to there to there, toe. So when they release the ball, the more they pivot, that's what spins the ball. Yeah? So these are the details that the 3D model generates. And it's not just that pivot. It's basically the pivot, the angular displacement here, and how straight your shoulder is, and the velocity at which the ball, the index finger flicks the ball. And that generates more spin. And also combined with the height of release. The lower I release, less of the spin. That's the case when they bowl a faster one. Yes? And then the next one is high speed motion analysis. I think most of you will know this. How many of you watch Discovery? Apart from Sun TV, Jaya TV, all that. Who watches Discovery? Come on, you watch Discovery, raise your hands. Yes, good.
Slow motion.
Have you seen a show called Time Warp? Yes. So that's what. They use high speed motion analysis there. They fill a balloon with water, they throw a needle, burst the balloon, and they show it in the slow motion. What's the big deal?
Number of frames.
Small balloon, TV, to take the money. But how can we make use of it here? So basically, for things like a jump, how much force is generated in the muscle? How much visual force is generated? That can be seen using high-speed motion analysis. The cameras might go to a depth of 10,000 frames per second, 25,000 frames per second. So 1 second, they split it into fractions of 25,000 frames. So when you combine that with other analysis software, it gives you a meaningful data. Is there anyone from North India here?
No, sir.
Anyone know? Good, because I'm using Tamil and I don't want you to get confused. I don't want you to miss out on anything. The next one is 3D modeling and simulation. This is the exciting part, okay? So now in the 3D motion analysis, you saw the model that we generated. So what we do now, this is where the biomechanists who are getting bored in the lab have fun. They make these 3D models, put them in a simulator. And then, the example that I showed, the finger release, the angular displacement here and all that, you can enter values. She's getting bored, I think. Or is she writing? Morning. So, what the biomechanists do in the simulator is fill in the data. The release point, they might enter a value of 25 kilometers per hour. The finger flicks at 25 kilometers per hour. There's an angular displacement, angular movement of 45 degrees at the wrist. And the pivot's about 120 degrees. And then they see the simulator perform. Model on the bayangarama podom, adu vandu inga pitch ay appdi spin aayittu pogum. Okay, so they find out optimum value. What is basically sports biomechanics? It's use of biomechanics to get optimum performance from an athlete, the same time reducing injuries. Yeah? So So what happens is, when they input the values in a simulator, this gives you an optimum performance. Now what they do, they try to try the athlete to do the same, to replicate the same. Certain things might not be in the control of athlete, because he's a human and models basically computer, right? So some of them might involve physical training of the athlete, or some of them might just go, that's not for the athlete to go to that level. So this is basically the simulator gives you an idea of optimum performance, and then you see if the athlete can do that using the right technique and reducing injury. So now, after I did my postgraduate degree, I had three questions in my mind. What was the first question? Okay, this side's been sleeping. I'll come back to you soon. Yes. What was the second question? What? Good morning. Third question was how? So the question I had was, so I've been studying this sports biomechanics, but why? So I started thinking. I told you that I'll come back to the previous slides. Yes? What did I say I was when I was in undergrad? I was a cricket player. Yes? I continued playing cricket when I was in my postgrad, which I didn't mention. And I started playing hockey when I started working with the Buffalo Men's Hockey Club. So sports was very close to me. So somewhere it was a dream for me that I want to do something in sports. Yes? And then the next was what? What am I going to do? I've learned so much. I've done an undergraduate degree. I've done a postgraduate degree. What am I going to do with it? That's when I started finding purpose. And that's what led me to how. How am I going to implement it? And that's when I found, you're all in college, okay? So don't lie. I found my love. Now most of you might already have. But then there's a small twist. My love was for Dada. Yeah, a bit boring for you, but exciting for me. So my love was data, numbers, statistics. How did I come here? I did my biomedical engineering here, then sports biomechanics, and then statistics. How? This is where why, what, and how helps. Okay? So while doing my sports biomechanics, we helped the athletes. And we did that thesis and stuff. Spin bowling, athlete information kurtache, he goes, practices, he gets better, done. We don't know what's going on there. I don't know how my inputs are being used there. That's when I started loving stats, because a part of biomechanics, the core of biomechanics, is statistics. You can't talk biomechanics just by using videos. Okay, gone are the days when coaching used to be done by using videos. So biomechanics, the core is statistics. Because even the previous slides where you saw the 3D models, the output that it gives in a software is not an image. It gives everything in numbers. And what I thought, or what I found out, was I was fantastic in numbers. Yeah? The more the numbers they give, the big tabular columns and everything, I was happy to sit down, think, and find out meaningful information out of it. That's what led me to statistics. Yeah? And now, like I said, it started exciting, boring. Then the exciting part comes now. So how did I use my statistics? You see that? All happy faces there. One of them is me there with a thumbs up, here without a thumbs up. So I started using my statistics skills for sport. So that's my workstation there in one of the major tournaments, Champions Trophy in England. And this is, can anyone guess? No. Olympics. That's the pitch there, and these are workstations. You can see the laptops here. So basically, I started using my statistics expertise in sports. I started talking the game in numbers. There's a coach who's been coaching a team for 30 years. Okay, I go to him, sir, what are you saying is wrong? How do you feel? Okay, naalik test la vande, they won't reduce any marks. Just in case, if you go to your teacher, I say, ma'am, neenga nadathirala thappu ma'am. How do they feel? So when you say something that strong, you have to have something to back you up. Yeah? And one thing that the coaches are good at, and I'm not good at, is coaching. But one thing that I'm good at and the coaches are not good at, is numbers. So I started talking the game in terms of numbers. So instead of going to the coach and saying, sir, what you're saying is wrong, I'd say to them, for example, Chaminda was fast bowled 10 bounces and the batsman was uncomfortable 8 number of times. For an example. Okay, that I know. What the coach will think, on the supera pota, adhe continue pan. Adhe abdiye pota, nalla pota. But then if I give him the stats, 8 times he was uncomfortable. Okay, but then, how was he uncomfortable? He just kept leaving the ball. And then the rendu ball kadichadu pathiya, hook 6. So is it good for the batsman or for the bowler?
Batsman.
So that's how I started talking the game. In terms of numbers, but they can't come and challenge me. Yeah? I started small. I started a Lufra men's hockey club. Yes, it was a premiership club, but then comparing to an international team was still low. So I started making statistical models at a very small scale. And then I started small to make it big. And that's how I chose performance analysis. Don't be overwhelmed. So that's basically a slide of a hockey pitch, or the hockey match analysis, a brief of it that I do in a game. I won't go into too much depth. So that's basically the goals, goal shots, blah, blah, blah. That's more blah, blah, blah there, and more blah, blah, blah. Yeah, so you won't understand right now. So what I started doing, I started talking the game in terms of numbers to make the players understand. Once the players realize that you're not threatening them, what you're doing with the numbers is basically helping them, they start understanding your game. They start understanding what you want to tell them. Same with the coaches. That's what I started to do. So today, I have worked with, I have had opportunities to work with top teams, England under 21, so I was not bluffing, okay, basically there. And I'm the only analyst in the Hockey India League who's been there in 3 finals, 3 different seasons, 3 finals, and 2016 we won it. And I've been a vital part of the Indian team. And I've won quite a few number of medals by now. That's World League Finals bronze medal. That is after 36 years. Indian team won a bronze medal in a major tournament. And then it just all started. Once you put in the effort, starting them kind of customer. If gym ponon solra, friends la solra, hey, on a parra, odamna fulla meengi kadakku, namna pono. ஸ்டார்டிங் வந்து கொஞ்சம் கஷ்டமாக இருக்கும். ஃபஸ்ட்டு போன உடனே ஒரு நாள் அடிச்சுட்டு 4 நாள் ரெஸ்ட் எடுப்பான். ஓகே, அதுவே ரெகுலராக போக ஆரம்பிச்சிட்டானா, ஒன்ஸ் இட் கோஸ் ரெகுலர் தென் இட்ஸ் ஈஸி. தட்ஸ் ஹவ் இட் ஸ்டார்டட். ஸ்டார்ட் வாஸ் டஃப். The first medal came after 36 years, but then there was more to follow. Champions Trophy silver, Commonwealth Games 2014 silver, Asian Games gold, and then the best for me, I was there at Olympics. So if I'm here today, I'm because I started with three simple questions. I hope when you go out of this room, it's just going, why, what, okay. I don't want you to use the question in a different way, okay? Naalik test padikala, yanda padikala, why didn't I study? What was I doing for so long? How? Don't think that way. Okay, go in the positive sense. So I started with three questions. It's time for you to start with the first question. Why? Why are you here? You've gone through 4 years now. Final year, pre-final year. It's even the pre-final year students have got a advantage on the hands. You don't have to react. You can start early. Start asking yourself the question, why? Why am I here? What am I going to do next? So you start asking yourself why and make it big. Thank you. The second promise was it'll be
interactive.
Any questions? Don't ask too many, too tough questions, okay? Okay, any questions? At least two from each side. Even stupid questions are okay. She's thinking. Anyone? Yes. So that's the thing. Okay, so when I finished my undergraduate degree, or when I was in my final year, I saw my friends, some of them getting placed in IT, some of them getting placed in biomedical companies. But then I had on back of my mind, I'm not ready to work. I'm just not ready. I'm not ready for the market right now. I want to learn more. Yeah? So that's when I started looking for universities for biomedical engineering, masters in biomedical engineering. I think the common mistake that most of you might make in this room is you're studying Bachelor of Technology here? Bachelor of Engineering in biomedical engineering. Right, okay. The common mistake that we might think of making is I should start working in a biomedical engineering company, or I should do a postgraduate degree in biomedical engineering. Everything biomed, I should talk biomed, I should eat biomed, I should drink biomed. No. Okay, start questioning yourself. It's not about what you learned in biomedical as a whole. You might have learned one module which you loved a lot. For me, it was biomechanics. Okay, so I started pursuing biomechanics, and then one of my friends suggested, you're so much into sports, why don't you do something in sports? I was like, Eureka, sports, biomechanics, done. So I started looking for universities. I started looking for brochures. The funny incident was, as soon as I opened Loughborough University's brochure, there was a cricket ground. What more do you need? A person who loves cricket, who watches test match, replay power, patadara potagura, and the match on the 10 times you have to see dedicatedly. I was that kind of crazy about cricket. Okay, so I started applying for different universities, and Loughborough, I figured out, was a top university that does sports research. So it's not just offering a course, it's also doing research. Okay, some of you go for higher studies from now, look for universities that does research. Don't go for university that just offers you a degree. Taught course. When you fall in love with, you'll have a taught course, there will be a research course. Masters by taught, masters by research. Okay, so go for the courses or go for the universities that does research, so that they will be up to date with the latest technology, and you can also learn. Yes, I hope that answers your question. More questions, please.
So what is your role other than data analysis?
Okay, so what my role is, right now, for the last 2.5 years, I have stuck myself to data analysis. Okay, and I call myself performance analyst, not a data analyst, not a video analyst, performance analyst. So the screen that I showed you is not something that came when I started doing it. Okay, the first time when I joined the team, that wasn't my screen. My screen was that small. I was doing limited data analysis. But then, the more you get into it, the more you realize that there's so much that he can put in. There's so much effort that he can put in, and there's so much that he can do that surprises yourself. So that is, performance analysis was one role. And now, I will answer this question with the conjunction from here. So let's say now I've done Olympics. What is bigger than Olympics? For a sports person, what can be bigger than Olympics? Nothing. Olympics is the topmost thing that a sports person can go to. But then, this is where the three questions come back again. You should start thinking again. Let's say now you have a dream. You're going to start asking yourself, how am I going to do that? You achieve that dream. And start asking yourself again, why? Why did I come this far? Why did I start? Yes? And then what did I learn? Okay, so I might have learned in, I don't even know what class it was, A plus B squared, whole squared is equal to A squared plus B squared plus 2AB. But that's it. Okay. 12th class vandha onne, adhu mattum yaavam irundha poruma? No. So you're learning more. So basically, your knowledge base grows. But this time you ask yourself, what have I learned in the whole process? And now, how I can implement that to make it bigger? Okay, so the next role that I might take, okay, I've not thought about it completely, the next role that I might take is groom more youngsters. So if any of you in this room presently, I'm being very honest, if any of you in this room is interested in this field, you can contact me. The teachers will have my number or my email IDs. Contact me. I'll at least get you through an interview process. You never know. If this is your dream, you might be making it successful. So now I'm taking a role of grooming youngsters. And sports analysis and biomechanics in India has got huge opportunity. And it's one field which has not been explored. No one knows what's there. இன்னுமோ வந்து அந்த டைனோசர் எப்படி வந்ததுன்னா பார்த்துட்டுருக்காங்களே தவிர இங்கே என்ன ஆகப்படுதுன்னா பார்க்கல யாரும். ஓகேவா? ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அ ஃபீல்ட் விச் யூ ஆல் கேன் எக்ஸ்ப்ளோர். சேலஞ்ச் யூர் செல்ஃப். ஒரு ஐடி ஜாபில் போயிட்டு காலத்தில் 9 to 5 வேலை பார்த்துட்டு மந்த் எண்ட்ல 20,000 சேலரி வந்தாச்சா, வீட்டில் நல்லா வடை பாயசத்தோடு சாப்பிட்றோமா உட்காந்துக்கலாம். தட் இஸ் நாட் லைஃப். யூ ஹாவ் டு சேலஞ்ச் யூர் செல்ஃப். இஃப் யூ சேலஞ்ச், சி திஸ் இஸ் யர் கம்ஃபர்ட் ஜோன் அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் வேர் த மேஜிக் ஹேப்பன்ஸ். Leave your comfort zone, go there. And that's when you know that there's so much ability in yourself. Any more questions? Yes. Have you got a mic?
No offense.
Okay.
So, we have it.
No. Bad question. So basically, this is like asking your teachers. They're teaching you. So what they're trying to do is make a machine that gets a 100% pass result. No. Performance analysis is a field which is growing every day. So let's say if today Team India has gone from here to there, other teams have done that as well. So basically, in sports field, what is the ultimate aim? To win. Yes? So you have to find out different ways to come up with solutions. And performance analysis is a part of it. That's why you have strength and conditioning coaches, you have nutritionists, so much. But then here, performance analysis is something that I feel very close to. And you know, once you put in the effort and the team does well, what more do you want? Same thing, when your teachers teach you so much, you score well. Like, for example, I give, I think everyone knows Sangeeta ma'am here. Yes?
Yes.
Yes? No? Maybe so. Okay. Okay. She taught me in Satyabhama. Okay? And today she feels proud that I'm here. My students here. Maybe she doesn't, maybe she doesn't. I'm just kidding. So that's how it is. When your students perform well, the teacher feels proud. So when the team does well, I feel proud. Does that answer? Okay. Any more questions? Yes.
For the 1 year, when your job applications are getting rejected, how did you react?
Yes. Fantastic question. I tell you what. Sometimes, when we're stressed, we make too many mistakes. We look for solutions outside, but the solution might just be there next to you. Yeah. So I was applying for jobs everywhere. Everywhere around the world, England, Australia, New Zealand, blah, 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 every place. But then one fine day, you know, sometimes or bulb area on Chattanooga. I'm at a university that does sports research at the highest level. Why shouldn't I make use of it? But that's when I started applying internally in the university. And straight away in a week's time, I got a reply saying, yes, we need someone. So, when you start getting rejections in your job application, don't step back. 440 applications. You won't even have that many companies in India. 440 applications. Whenever you get rejected, thank you, sir. At least he replied back. So at least he has my profile in his system. He might come back tomorrow. Yeah? Or else you might get an experience somewhere. Naliki in the company will wait when he says, sir, can you work for us? Then you say, you would have 50 lakhs put up 1 year and I'll have a bag. It's the same company. That should be the motivation. Don't put yourself down if the companies reject you. Okay? Just keep upskilling yourself. Keep, again, stress. Learn the skills. Don't learn the textbook. Don't just read what's there in black and white. Learn the skills. Because the skills are something that's going to help. When I said I used to be passionate about singing, I'm still. Why? That's a skill. It helps you when you're stressed. When these sort of stuff happens, when your applications get rejected, your girlfriend leaves you, boyfriend leaves you for you. That time, these soft skills, someone might have interest in painting, some people might have interest in singing, some might have interest in dancing. These are all soft skills. These help you shape your career. Don't ever think little of these, because these are major things that help you in your career, in your life. More questions? I've had 1, 2, 3, 4. Come on. Yes. Yes. So I showed you one of the photos where I was standing with an iPad and I had two players on my shoulder. Go back. She didn't see it. That's the most exciting part. There it is. So basically, this getting one-on-one with a player wouldn't happen straight away. It's basically a process. Once they start trusting what you're doing is correct, that's when your role becomes more hands-on. Okay, but now we have a team joined. We have 200 caps. We have to stand. How do you feel? That's how it is. Once you show him that there is something, if you're saying something, there's something that is backing up your, there's a backup because of which you're presenting this view, then they'll start listening. Did you know me before I came here?
So I'm still the makeup artist that needs recognition.
Okay, I'll tell you how. In sports field, the recognition does come your way. If you see, I started at Loughborough Hockey Men's Hockey Club, or Loughborough Students Men's Hockey Club. From there, under 21. How did that happen? I kept on doing my work at Loughborough Men's Hockey Club. I didn't know that England hockey is going to happen. But then there was a reference sent from Loughborough Hockey Club to England Hockey. There is this person who's worth it. Try him. I did that. I came back to India. My dream, I told my friend once when I started working in hockey, I told my friend, she asked me, what are you going to do? Why are you going in the sports field? I said, I have a dream that I want to work with an Indian team. That was my dream. And then in 2014, that came a reality. I came back to India, I started working Hockey India League team, and I only worked for that season, and I went back to work, went back to my office. I didn't know what was going to come. March 9th, 2014, I got a call that you've been called by the national team. So that's how the recognition grows. You keep doing your work. What is that in Gita? In Bhagavad Gita they say, right,
karma,
keep doing your work, don't think about the end result. Just keep doing your work, the recognition will come. Did I answer your question? Come on, there's one, three. Okay, one more question.
What are the other opportunities other than performance analysis in sports?
You can, if you love biomechanics, why not do it? Or maybe in biomedical engineering, I don't know if you have nanotechnology? Yes. So some of you might be interested in nanotechnology. Go for it. Everyone has different dreams. Everyone has different dreams, different ways of functioning. So whatever your dream is, chase it. That's my main point here. If you have a dream, chase it. Okay, if IT level background the starting package is 45,000 irukalam. Ungalku vandu or 5000 rupaya kadaikalam. Don't put yourself down. I'll tell you, when I started working in the sports field, my friends were getting paid 2 lakhs per annum, 2 lakhs per month. My package wasn't great. But then those people who were earning multiple times than my income, they used to say, actually, the work that you're doing is more satisfying than me. He might have a big bungalow, a car and all that, but can he win the Olympics experience that I have? Can any sort of money buy that experience? No. So if you have a dream, chase it. Don't put yourself down. Amma idu pandra, amma compare pannanga, appa compare pannanga. Thank you, Amma. Thank you, Appa. That's how adamant I was. My parents have told me so many times, change the field. No. I listened to them, thank you. Out. Yeah? So that's how you should be. If you have a dream, chase it. Is that it? Was it boring?
No, sir.
Thank you. Might have different ways of doing things. For example, cricket or hockey, I can't use the same, I can use statistics, but then in a different way. Same thing, let's say example of javelin throw in athletics. So I can't use the same set of statistics to generate a result that is useful. So what I might use, things like force platforms that I explained to you, because in javelin throw, which I used to practice at some point, so the release point, the distance that you throw, that's got a few factors that influences it. One, the release point, where you release the javelin. Your vertical velocity has to be less than the horizontal velocity. If you give the vertical velocity too much, it'll go higher but not further. Yeah? At the same time, when you run, when you thump your feet, that force that you generate, that's directly proportional to the distance that you travel. So these are the different factors which might differ from different sports. The best way to learn it is read journal articles. Read lots of journal articles, beat any field, and update yourself, and I think that should give you
the answer. One or two common things for all the games which we have to analyze?
I would say field.
Experiment to a student in sports biomechanics. So what would be the ideal parameter which we can teach them?
Depends on what you're going to find out. If it's long distance running or short distance running, be it sprint or be it 5,000 meters or be it a marathon, it's all running. Basically, gait analysis might be the same, but then the other parameters changes. Because a person who runs longer distance will need more cardio development than his muscle fiber. Someone like Usain Bolt might not have as much cardiovascular ability than Mo Farah, who runs a marathon of 10,000 meters, but his fast twitch fibers is what helps him run faster. But then the concept that might be similar is gait, but then how you make use of it. Yes, 1, 2, 3, good. Yes, true, but then I'm a very small fish in the whole ocean. So I only started. So like I said, I've reached one goal, but that's not the end. I'm only 28 years old, come on, I'm supposed to live. At least, I won't live at least till I'm 80 years old. Okay. So obviously I'll have dreams. So as I go forward, I'll set up certain targets. Paralympics might be one of the targets as we go. We'll find out what they are. You had a question? No, she had a question. That was a bad choice. It wasn't a bad choice. So I was an MBBS aspirant. But then there was this cricket that was introduced in my school on 11th and 12th. I went
clean.
I went too much into sports. So the guy who was the top performing student till 10 became a decent performing student and a brilliant cricket player. So MBBS, the dream dropped. So I thought, okay, I'd like to do something in medical field. And the medical field took me to sports and then here. Any questions?